Namaste. We came across the fulcrum of the Panchamahabhutas, that is Agni, in our previous video. We tried to understand in detail how Agni is formed and what Agni is in a literal sense and also in the metaphysical sense. We also got to know a lot more interesting facts about Agni Mahabhuta. Since this video is going to be a sequel to our previous videos, it is highly recommended that you watch the previous videos of the Panchamahabhuta series first so as to get a better grip of the contents of this video. Let's dive into this video on Jala Mahabhuta, or the element of water. But let me inform beforehand that to understand Jala in its full sense, our thought process should be supple like water, which takes the shape of whichever vessel we used to store it. Simply Ayurveda is an initiative to explore and share the contents of the vast science of Ayurveda in an easy manner. Consider subscribing to our channel. Agne Rapaha. As we learnt in the previous videos, the Mahabhutas sequentially create the next Mahabhutas. Hence, Jala is formed from Agni Mahabhuta. How does Agni create Jala? Agni, which is the entity of heat and energy, starts losing its innate energy or vibrations, thus forming an entity which is more stable and cold. This entity is Jala Mahabhuta. In other words, the complete dynamics of the conversion of Akasha to Prithvi indicate a fusion reaction. What is fusion reaction? It is an energy releasing reaction wherein two subatomic particles fuse into a larger one. Fusion of lighter nuclei releases energy, which is an exothermic reaction, while the fusion of heavier nuclei requires energy for the atomic bonds to form, which is an endothermic reaction. Let us apply this to our Mahabhutas. We know that from Akasha to Prithvi, the Sthulata and Ganata of the Bhutas increase. The conversion of Vayu to Agni is thus an exothermic reaction because these are more subtle. But since the bonds of Jala are more stronger and the entity is more stable, it absorbs heat and energy from the surroundings, thus indicating an endothermic reaction which makes Jala cold. This is explained as Shita Sparsha Tyapaha. Jala is cold to touch. This highlights the fact that the nature of Jala is to absorb heat by virtue of its mass and stronger bonds. Let us now look into some of the other interrelated gunas of Jala. Snigdhata. It refers to the cohesiveness or the binding energy or the chemical bonds which are responsible for the mass and stability of the entities. This in turn is responsible for Shitatva, as we explained previously. Keeping the above statement in our mind, we can say that not all liquid entities are predominantly Jaliya in nature from the purview of Snigdhata. Take into consideration petrol, alcohol, nail polish remover, etc. These are volatile in nature, or in other words, these are liquids whose chemical bonds are easily broken and hence lack the Snigdha Guna and are more Agneya in nature. Thus, we can state that only those entities which are responsible for binding together by absorbing energy are Jalabhuta Pradana. This guna of Snigdhata may also be the reason for the idea or the theory of water memory, which postulates that water can retain memory. Let's now look into Dravatva. This guna not only indicates liquidity or fluidity, but also their logical counterparts in the solid state of matter like malleability, ductility, tensility, and elasticity. Dravatva refers to that property of materials which allows them to deform under compressive stress. It allows the substance to keep bending or changing shape and not breaking by virtue of its stronger bonds. Dravatva is an attribute of Pitta Dosha also. This is one of the reasons why Pitta Prakriti people can gain and lose weight easily. The next guna is interrelated to both snigdhata and dravatva and is mandatva. Due to the strong bonds, the jalapradhana dravyas act slowly, similar to how sustained release drugs and modified release drugs act. These strong binding forces see to that the dravyas don't dissolve or disintegrate rapidly. So we looked into the four of the prime gunas of Jala Mahabhuta, which are Sheetata, Snigdhata, Dravatva and Mandatva. As in our previous videos, we will now understand the detailed explanation of Jala according to Tarka Sangraha. Sheeta Sparshavatyapaha Tadvividaha Nitya Anityascha Nityaha Paramanu Rupaha Anityaha Karya Rupaha Taha Punastrividaha Sharira Indriya Vishayabhedat Shariram Varuna Loke Indriyam Rasagrahakam Rasanam Jihvagravartihi Vishayaha Sarit Samudradihi. Apa or Jala is that which has cold touch. It exists in two states, the eternal or nitya state having paramana rupa and the perishable or anitya state which is the karya rupa. The karya rupa exists in three forms. Jaliya sharira is the varuna loka made of jala bhuta. The indriya corresponding to jala is rasana indriya or the gustatory faculty which is present at the exterior or the surface of the tongue. The vishayas or objects include all the water bodies like the seas, rivers and lakes. Some authors also mention the presence of four types of jala or the four stages of jala. Ambha is the most subtle state of jala and is known to be present in the Parameshti Mandala, which is our known galaxy. Check out the links in the description box for more information regarding this. Marichi is the jala present between the Surya Mandala and the earth, where it is acted upon by the sun rays. Mara is the jala which exists on the surface of earth like rivers and lakes. And the fourth one is Aap, which is the jala found under the surface of earth like well water. We had mentioned that Jalabhuta is responsible for rasana or gustatory sense. Let us analyze this with a simple experiment. Try to blow dry your mouth. Temporarily, the oral cavity loses its predominance of Jala Tattva, right? Now, place a piece of food on your tongue. Are you able to taste the food as you usually do? No, right? This is because Jala Tattva is required to bind the molecules present in the food to the receptors of Rasanendriya, which is responsible for the perception of taste. Acharya Vagbhata states the principle of Ambu Yoni. He opines that life originates from Jala or Ambu. This is proved and accepted in the present day. Check out the links in the description box for more information regarding this. Among the platonic solids, icosahedron is a solid with 20 faces which represents the Jala Mahabhuta. This mudra is utilized by Indians to rever Jala Mahabhuta. We have come to the end of this video, and before you close this window, consider subscribing to our channel and like the video. Comment your opinions and do follow us on Instagram and Facebook.